medal achieved on their third match point. And the world champions, Wang Xiao Li and Yu Yang, lift the coveted trophy once again. A standing ovation from some of the fans, and rightly so. That was absolutely magnificent. Three games, very nearly an hour and 20 minutes, just shy of that. And Wang Xiao Li and Yu Yang win the match 21-17, 18-21, 23-21 in the deciding game. This, the final rally. Great skill from the front of the court from Wang Xiao Li, and look at the delight. What a terrific match for Yu Yang. Seven finals in 7 years, and her list of titles grows once again. Fantastic first match on finals day at the All England Championships.
A chance to get a word then with our champions, Wang Xiao Li and Yu Yang. Angela is going to translate for us. Ladies, what a fantastic final. Congratulations. How does it feel to be champions again at the All England?
首先恭喜你们取得一场非常精彩的胜利。 可以跟我们分享一下你们夺得桂冠的喜悦吗?
First of all, I want to thank all the British fans here to give us all the support. You guys are amazing. I think playing at the All England here, there's this amazing atmosphere. And today, this is the first title this year for us. So thank you all for your support.
Fabulous. And just briefly, a word about your opponents, because that was a fantastic final.
可不可以给我们讲讲你们对今天对手的表现的感觉？因为今天打的真的非常精彩。首先恭喜我马静和唐渊婷，特别是小队员唐渊婷第一次参加全英比赛，就获得这么好的成绩。首先恭喜他。然后今天因为我们是内战对内比赛，所以呢今天我们就心态非常的放松，希望能给英国的观众和球迷一场精彩的比赛。他们今天也打得非常出色，我们今天也发挥了自己正常的水平。First
of all, we want to congratulate Ma Jing and Tang Yuanting, especially Tang Yuanting. As a young player, this is her first performance at the All England, and she got an amazing result. Second of all, we want to, because today the match is between the Chinese players, we are relatively relaxed coming into this match. We just perform really well and bring an amazing match to all the spectators here.
Thank you very much. Wang Xiao Li, Yu Yang, our women's doubles champions.
Well, how very nicely said by the champions, Wang Xiao Li and Yu Yang. I'm absolutely delighted to say that I've been joined by the president of the BWF, the Badminton World Federation, a newly elected IOC member, Paul Erik Hoyer Larsen. First of all, many congratulations on your election to the IOC.
Thank you very much.
And Paul Erik, of course, we've just witnessed one of the most magnificent women's doubles, but lots of people will be talking about the fact that for a 14th time in 15 years, it's a Chinese pair that have taken the women's doubles. I know with your IOC hat on that there has been talk at Olympic level about one nation dominating in our sport. And whilst, of course, that, you know, there are a lot of youngsters coming up, is there something that you can see from your IOC level to help encourage and develop badminton globally?
Of course, there is a concern from the IOC that there should be a spread of medals, and also looking at the sports to be worldwide sports. There is not really a program on the highest level, but we have an Olympic social program where there is a possibility for young people actually to tap in and to get Olympic grants. But I think it's up to badminton to actually, the countries by themselves, to develop. China is doing really well. We cannot avoid that they do have a lot of very good badminton players. So it is a bit of a concern as well in ladies singles. I think China is really dominating right now.
Yeah, well, of course, we've got an all-China women's singles final, our third final of the day. There's a lot of very positive things, though, that we'll discuss in a moment about other nations coming through. But let's take our hats off, first of all, to Margin and Tang Huanting. Their seventh match this week in the women's doubles, because they had to come through the qualifying event. And especially to the youngster Tang Huanting, what a performance she gave today. I know she's having to settle for second best, but in my opinion, she is a champion in the making. Of course, Margin, well, she's been an All-England champion in the mixed doubles 3 years ago. First final at women's doubles. But what a performance they gave today, and indeed all week. Champions for a third time of the All England Championships, Wang Xiaoli and Yu Yang, in their fourth consecutive final, to add to the titles won in 2011 and last year. They are the champions of the Yonex All England 2014.
And the Lord Mayor of Birmingham will also present the MetLife Snoopy mascots.
Councillor Mike Leddy, Lord Mayor of Birmingham, presenting the gold medals.
The Coventry Trophy from Paul Jensen from Yonex UK.
Mr. Paul Jepson, Managing Director of Yonex UK,
will
present the trophies.
From China,
worthy champions once again, Wang Xiaoli and Yu Yang. Paul, Eric, while they pose for the photographers, just going back to what we were discussing with China being so dominant, especially in the women's events, I'd really like to point out that at the World Championships last year we had four players on the podium from four different nations, so already there are very positive signs that other countries are doing exactly as you suggested. They are developing their own players and they are coming through.
Yes, they certainly are, and I'm very happy to see Thailand, Japan and Korea as well. They're tapping in now, and actually they're delivering almost on the same level, or at the same level as China is. So there will be a spread. Right now it's in Asia, but I mean, we should learn from that and say, well, it can be done, it is possible. So I do believe within a good kind of workload, it is possible for Europe also to be represented in the ladies' categories.
Well, here at the All England, we've actually had a Canadian for the first time in 35 years at quarter-final stage. So not only Europe, there is also development in the rest of the world as well.
Yeah, I think it really looks positive. We see that overall picture. There is definitely a good sign, positive sign for us to really represent worldwide the sport, and Canada all of a sudden coming in. I think it's very, very important for us.
Absolutely, and of course our next final on court as the women's doubles winners take their lap of honour. The next final on court features the number one and two seeds, the Indonesians Muhammad Hassan and Hendra Setiawan, up against the number two seeds, Hiroyuki Endo and Kenichi Hawakawa. Japan have a chance to win their first All England title of any man in any category at the All England. So again, there's another nation coming in fighting for the top prize.
Yes, definitely. And if you look at the junior level, you can actually see Japan winning the men's singles World Junior Championships. And recently, just half a year back, it was the 16 years old Yamaguchi from Japan winning the ladies singles. So actually, they are really producing some good players and they're promising for the future.
Absolutely. So, badminton, whilst your colleagues in the IOC may have concerns when they watch our showcase event, of course every badminton player's dream is winning the Olympic Games, and of course you remain the only European ever to win an Olympic gold medal. But please go back to the IOC and please tell them that we're in the development stage, things are changing, and there are many, many more nations coming up to challenge the dominance of Asia.
Certainly, this underlines that there is definitely an interest of developing the sport, developing good players from other countries. And I also do believe that we are an Olympic sport and there will be other nations all of a sudden investing programs, putting programs for the players in place. And then we will see a development not only in the Asian countries, but I do believe and I'm positive that it will happen in other areas as well.
Yes, and of course there's been talk in many sports when players and pairs play each other from the same nation, as we've just seen in the women's doubles, that matches can be a little flat. Again, we've just seen the most magnificent badminton, terrific fighting spirit. Again, that's a very positive sign for our sport.
It certainly is, and I must be totally honest, I think actually a lot of times ladies doubles is more entertaining than men's doubles, because they actually are producing a high level and continuously rally point, the rallies is longer, so I think it's perfect.
Well, what a wonderful way to get us off on finals day at the Yonex All England Championships. Next up is men's doubles, Mohamed Hassan and Hendra Setiawan against Kenichi Hawakawa and Hiroyuki Endo.
It's the men's doubles final. Let's hear it for the number one seeds from Indonesia, Mohamed Hassan and Hendra Setiawan.
The world champions, the world number ones, the number one seeds at the All England Championships, Mohamed Hassan and Hendra Setiawan. Setiawan, so many titles to his name, world and Olympic champion, but never an All England title. And I'm starting to lose
control. And let's hear it for their opponents from Japan, the number two seeds, Hiroyuki Endo and Kenichi Hayakawa.
Kenichi Hawakawa and Hiroyuki Endo, a second consecutive year that they take center stage on finals day. Last year, they were desperately nervous. That's understandable. They lost out to Liu Xiaolong and Chu Sihan. Of the coin. Looks like the Japanese pair have won the toss and looks like they wish to start the far end, or maybe he was pointing towards his partner saying Hawakawa will serve.
So it's the men's doubles final then, Mohamed Hassan.
So the number one and two seeds. The only other.
Hayakawa, Mohamed Hassan and Hendra Setiawan are the world champions.
Finals of men's singles and mixed doubles to feature. The number one and two. Hendra Setiawan on the left as we look at them, the 29-year-old from the ancient city of Malang in East Java. His partner, 26, from Palembang in South Sumatra. Last year, they were beaten semi-finalists here at the All England, but they went on to take the World Championship gold medal, beating Boa Mogensen from Denmark at the World Championships last year in Guangzhou. At this year's All England, well, they had a battle in the second round against England's Chris Langridge and Peter Mills, went the full distance there. But their semi-final yesterday against teammates Gideon Marcus Fernaldi and Setiawan's former partner Marcus Kido was astonishing. It was 21 minutes only for 21-7, 21-12. The world champions, quite simply, were on fire. So to their opponents and the number two seeds, up one place in the world ranking this week to number two, a career high number two, Kenichi Hawakawa on the left as we look at them. 27 years of age, although he'll turn 28 next month. Hiroyuki Endo, 27. And as I say, they were beaten finalists from last year. This year's All England, well, they had their problems. A couple of times went the full distance, including the semi-final, the last match on yesterday against Go Sung-hyung and Shinbek Chol, lost the opening game but came back strongly in the decider. Well, it's the second final in 2 weeks for the Japanese pair. They were beaten finalists at the German Grand Prix Gold a week ago. So a good start to the year. Their first two Super Series events of 2014, two semi-finals. There is our umpire,
ready to play.
Jakob Sundberg. Paraka Andersson of Sweden will be our service judge. So the number two seeds there, the Japanese pair, second consecutive All England final. A second final in 2 weeks, having been beaten in the final of the German Open. They are on a winning streak. They're playing very well, but so too is this pair, the world champions. Endra Sertiawan and Mohamed Hassan. There's Mohamed Hassan, the 26-year-old, his partner, 3 years older. And for Endra Sertiawan, Olympic champion in Beijing, world champion in 2007.
Championships men's doubles final. Between, on my right, Kenichi Hayakawa, Hiroyuki Endo, Japan. And on my left, Hendra Setiawan, Mohamed Hassan, Indonesia.
The world champions nearest to us.
Hayakawa to serve to Mohamed Hassan, love all, play.
The Indonesians, Hassan and Setiawan. They've been so good since they formed their partnership. But the one title missing for Hendra Setiawan is an All England title. Now, I'm absolutely delighted to say that joining me is President of the BWF, the Badminton World Federation, and newly elected IOC member, Paul Erik Hoyer Larsen. Oh, my goodness, but Paul Erik, we were discussing just a moment ago the quality of the women's doubles, and already this men's doubles of the very, very highest quality.
Indeed, the speed in this game, we will see some tremendous drives over the net, speed towards the net, and it will be very interesting to see who will get the best control of this game. And I think Indonesia right now has the upper hand, but it's the best in the world we are seeing on the court right now.
Yeah. Well, you talk about getting an upper hand when you look at the five previous matches that these two pairs have played against each other. The Indonesians have won on all five occasions. So it's a tall order for the Japanese pair, but I suppose having learned from last year's experience being in the final, that could help them today. Nothing to lose.
Well, they feel they have nothing to lose, everything to win. Still, they are facing the number one in the world, and they have gained confidence over the last year, being in many semi-finals and finals. So I'm sure that they will definitely come up with something against the Indonesian pair.
Yeah. And of course, no Japanese man has ever won a title here at the All England Championships. In fact, the last Japanese winners were women's doubles Takeda and Takada 36 years ago. So history could be made today. And that's another issue, because as you and I were chatting a little bit earlier about the dominance in women's doubles, women's singles later on, the Chinese dominance in the women's disciplines, here we have an opportunity for another nation to come in this discipline of men's doubles and showcase to the world that it's not just one nation dominating badminton.
Absolutely not, and we can see Indonesia is really holding on, not only to the men's doubles, they actually have been having some fantastic men's doubles over many, many years.
Yeah.
But also the mixed doubles, it's really open, and right now Indonesia also producing really well. So I do think that we have other nations that are able to tap in now and show the very best of badminton, not only from China, but actually it's coming from other nations as well.
Yeah, well, I think the All England draw here in the men's doubles, emphasizing that at quarterfinal stage, six different nations involved. Semi-final stage, there were no Chinese pairs left in. And these two pairs are the number one and two pairs in the world at the moment. So this is the best of the best.
Well,
the Indonesians very definitely have their favoured formation. Hendra Setiawan, so effective at the front of the court. He intercepts so well, reads the game so well. His partner, Mohammad Hassan, is so quick at the back of the court. No, he's not really too slow at the front there either.
Definitely not. I mean, this is definitely right now a game on who is getting the control at the net, and they are forcing themselves, pushing them towards the net all the time, and not want to give away the offensive position.
Well, there is a prime example of the capabilities of Hendra Setiawan at the front of the court. How on earth did he find that angle? Just look at this. Looks as if he's going to play a hard, fast shot and then just guides the shuttle across court. Absolutely delightful. I think back 12 months and
7-6.
I really felt so sorry for Hawakawa and Endo. They looked absolutely crippled by nerves. They look far more aggressive and far more confident already this year. How much do you think the fact that Setiawan has achieved virtually everything there is to achieve in the game, world and Olympic titles, and yet this All England, which has been the oldest and most traditional event, very, very prestigious event, the All England Championships, and it's sort of been the one tournament that's missing from his CV. Does that add pressure?
Definitely. I do believe that he really wants to have this title, and that can create some eagerness, and when you're too eager sometimes you fail, and even though I would say he's clever, he maybe is at the stage of his career that he can control it, but you never know when it's really getting close what will happen, and that could be the mental side of it really wanting, and then all of a sudden lose it.
Yeah. Good aggression from the Japanese pair. Hiroyuki Endo at the front of the court. Very athletic.
10-8.
Having to arch his back to play that shot with the round the head action. He's so fast as this man, Mohammad Hassan.
Ten.
Good rally. Goodness me. And it is the Japanese pair, the number two seeds, who have a 2-point advantage at the mid-game interval of the opening game. Coach Park Jubong. Well, surely he's pretty happy with his men at the moment. And poor Eric, just tell us with your IOC hat on the importance of the Olympic status for us as a pair. I'm just thinking back to the first Olympic Games in Barcelona in 1992, when badminton became a full Olympic sport. It doesn't just create history in sporting terms, it's bigger than that, because I remember the Indonesians winning gold medals. It was their first ever gold medals in any sport, and therefore through badminton, the Olympic movement and the IOC was spreading its wings through our sport, which again is a very good thing for us as a sport of badminton.
It certainly is, and not only the interest from each country, it's also money-wise. I mean, you want to invest as a nation to have this chance to experience such joy, such happiness, unites the nation. That is actually what is happening when you have the Olympics, and that was exactly what happened in Indonesia when Susi Susanti came back home with Alan Kusuma, having such a success at the 92 Olympics in Barcelona. That united the nation. So these moments is for us a possibility now because we are in the Olympics.
Yeah. So important. Well, the shuttle actually getting stuck in the strings there. Yeah, you can see why the strings broke where it was hitting the shuttle at the edge of the racket head there. And you need to be hitting it on the sweet spot in the centre of the racket. Oh, it was very evident 2 years ago how the Olympics can bring a nation together here with the London Olympics. It was honestly, I know I'm biased being British, but you know, I've been working or competing at Olympics since badminton's first involvement, and I have to say it was very, very special Olympic Games. And I know the players on courts, this is what they all build towards, and it is that 11, coming together 13. Of the whole nation. We see it in football when there's high drama at World Cups and so on, and despair if a team loses, but there'll be badminton fans all over the world right now watching this match, and nations coming together, and that's the beauty of sport, isn't it?
It certainly is, and that's definitely the key thing for sports. This environment is so unique in that aspect, so therefore Olympics is definitely an area where, I mean, everybody is allowed to be part of the Olympics. And also I experienced in London 12 how well received this Olympics were taken from the citizens of London, but also the whole United Kingdom. Actually, I felt they were joining in, and they experienced some wonderful days with the Olympics in London.
Yeah. Well, this match, quite frankly, is getting better and better. It started well. More rackets broken.
To me, it seems a bit like the Japanese is forcing themselves to have one person in front of the net, 14, and then the other one 12. Right behind him, waiting for the opportunity, but the front person really chasing each and every shuttle coming towards him.
Yeah. Oh, service fault called, struck above the waist, says the service judge. Oh, Riker Andersson from Sweden. Well, a little quizzical look from Hawakawa. Oh, good spot. Yeah, above the waist. Now, just to explain, Nanda, just watch his left arm, how he raises that left arm to play the flick serve, and that's why it's called a fault. Shuttle must be struck below the waist, and the waist defined as below the lowest rib.
15-13.
Attack by the Indonesians. Obviously very, very important. Oh, well taken. Place at the right time.
16-14.
And it certainly was a magnificent shot, this cross backhand lift, so to speak, and then follow through into the position at the net and killing it. You've seen these kind of opening the court by the cross shot, and it has been a success both for the Japanese but also for the Indonesians right now.
Acutely aware of how important every single point is. Oh, it's a good rally again. And it's all level.
16 all.
Oh, my goodness, he slipped Mohammed Hassan as he landed on the carpets around the courts. That appears to be okay. My goodness me, my heart missed a beat there. Gone long.
17-16.
Three straight points for the Indonesians. Oh, brilliant. Oh, no! That is sensational! Dive first of all from Endo. How on earth did he get that back? Well, he certainly can't accuse them of lack of effort.
Oh, that was really incredible, agile, and the way he was able to act with his racket, controlling the shot.
Diving away from the court, and it still had the 16. Racket head control to hit the shuttle in the opposite direction. Four straight points now for the Indonesians.
Oh,
That's landed well in. Well, we've been talking about the drift. There is a slight sideways drift from right to left as we look down on the court, and that drift brought this shot back in. And it was well in. Five straight points. And the run continues, and now it's game point opportunities. Four of them, to be precise. Well, that's probably about as angry as you'll ever see Andre Cepion yet. Off the top of the tape and went wide, and three game points have come and gone. Just one more remains for the Indonesians.
19-20.
Yeah, fight one.
On their fourth opportunity, the world champions take the opening game 21-19. 21 minutes. Well, what a good opening game. 21-19. And the world champions are one game away from the All England title. Well, poor Eric Lawson has sadly had to leave us and go and do his other duties as president of the BWF. Delighted to say that Morten Frost is back with us. What a good opening game, Morten.
It was. I was sitting down by the players watching it because there's not much room up here. So I was sitting down there and it was wonderful to watch. Great, great match. And I can tell you, even their compatriots sitting down there, they enjoy the badminton as well. So it's good.
Fantastic. Well, from some of their gestures, the Indonesian coaches, you wouldn't believe that their men have just won the opening game, seem to be very intense, trying to encourage them and urge them on. Well, with Paul Erik Hoyer Larsen, the president of the BWF and IOC member, he's had to go and deal with other duties, so Morten Frost is back with me. Morten, you were just...
I do apologize.
Just telling me that you've been sitting courtside watching that opening game.
I have. It was wonderful.
Yeah.
Great intensity, really, really quick badminton.
Some terrific rallies. You and I have been talking at times, and in fact, Paul Eric was mentioning to me that he thought sometimes women's doubles was more entertaining nowadays than men's doubles. But my goodness, the opening game had just about everything, didn't it?
It did. Very much. I agree that we talked about it on numerous occasions earlier this week about the men's doubles and how quick it is and short rallies and all that. But this one here is excellent.
Yeah. And what a contrast to last year with Hayakawa and Endo. Last year, absolutely crippled with nerves. This year, my goodness, I think they're playing about just as well as I've ever seen them.
Yeah, it's excellent. Really good.
Idea.
Three, two.
Oh, my goodness me. Take that.
Yeah, obviously not knowing what has been said in the first game here, but
I
can't recall I've seen anyone as quick as Indo in that men's doubles. His legs, they're so quick. We've seen occasions where he's jumping and almost landing out on the carpet on the blue. And the next split second, he's opposite, smashing again.
Well, remarking earlier on, Morton, about the speed of Mohamed Hassan, but I bow to you because you're absolutely right. I mean, there was a couple of occasions, Endo. Also, a couple of dives for him that were just extraordinary.
Yeah, but they're very similar style. I agree with you on that.
Yeah. Disguise.
The Japanese player is asking for it in my book. The defensive stance is really quite far back, and obviously it's opening up for these opportunities of drop shots, blocks and so on. So they were really asking for it here.
I was looking back at the record books, Morton, I was really quite surprised.
That Japan has never
won any men's title.
Yeah, any men's title. I thought it was only men's doubles.
No, I couldn't find a men's singles winner or a mixed doubles winner.
Yeah, that's amazing. Such a good nation.
Yeah.
Five.
But also astonishing to me is the fact that it's 11 years since the last Indonesian winners of the All England. Chandra Wijaya and Sigit Budiarto back in 2003.
Is that 11 years ago?
Yeah. And we think of one great Indonesian men's doubles player after another.
Yeah.
7-5.
Oh, good flick serve.
Very quick. supposed to get away with that. Oh, the Indonesians are really playing well now. Total control in this rally as well. Finding the gap the whole time, adding on the pressure, and makes it a really easy finish.
8-5.
Somebody's saying look for that one around the head. Well, the Japanese pair have to be awfully careful here.
Yeah, they've got to reinvent themselves now.
Yeah. Into that defensive shot, that was much better.
It was. Closing the gap.
There's your quick man again, Morton.
Yep. Don't do that.
Bounced off the top of the tape and went over.
10-8.
Defensive play from the Japanese pair. Work rate play from Mohamed Hassan at the back of the court.
Yeah, and then getting caught and then just an easy finish at the net after all that hard work.
Disappointed. That was a golden opportunity for Hiroyuki Endo, and the Indonesians go to the mid-game interval with a two-point advantage. Always very expressive.
Been around for many years.
Yes. Has made since he's been coaching in Japan.
Yeah, he's been lifting not just a few players but a whole system.
Yeah. Different that the Japanese pair should be doing, Morton?
No, I think they managed to save the situation and now it's only 1 point adrift. And, you know, stick to what they've done so far now, I would do that. But had they been 11-5 down, they had to do something differently. Yeah.
Characteristic error from Mohamed Hassan. On the back level.
But there's no doubt that the Japanese pair is a little bit more prepared to defend and then counter-attack when opportunities arises. That's where the Indonesians are just incredible.
12-11.
Yeah, it's amazing. This man hardly seems to move, but he's always in the right place at the right time.
He is. Quick, quick racket. Back level, 12-12.
12-12.
The Indonesians here almost saving the situation, even though it was pretty desperate. He's got to lift it.
Yeah, trying to be a little too cute.
For too low a position to do anything. Hassan, really working well, and he gives 100% in every single one of those matches.
14-13.
Turn two.
15-14.
This just skims the net. In fact, there was a net caught on the reply. Point for point.
15-all.
We had a crack of the women's doubles, and now we're having a crack of the men's doubles.
Yeah.
It's nice when it happens on these final days.
Yeah.
Sometimes it does fizzle out.
Yeah.
though. But didn't manage to get all the way on top of the tape. And well read. And that's what I like about, I wouldn't say this new Japanese duffel, but what I like about this duffel player is that they seem to be more tactical, aware and astute.
Yeah, you think in the past maybe it was all
fast and furious.
Yeah, I agree.
And here they have a better eye for it.
Mm.
And that's what I enjoy a lot.
Better variation, better thinking.
Yeah.
16 all.
That interception there is really good. A chance to take
17,
really trying to force his way through, and this one, that one is coming there. That's a very, very risky shot when you have Setiaman standing there.
Here from Mohamed Hassan, 1, 2, 3. Yeah. Proving that he too can play from the net, and the Indonesians just 2 points away from the title.
19-17.
In the World Championship final was Mohamed Hassan, and he's kept his
20,
intensity.
Point,
the last few rallies he's been outstanding again, and he and his partner now on the verge of victory. 3 match point opportunities.
Here it comes.
Oh, it's called good. There's a challenge.
Challenge.
There's a challenge on match point.
They have to challenge it.
It was called good. I thought it was long. Ooh.
It's in. It's in. According to what we can see here, it clips the line.
Oh, it's out.
Oh, yeah.
And the judgment is made.
Yes.
18,
and the Japanese
20.
Pair are given a lifeline.
Is not bad. He was scared that there will be a follow-up. He's got the back to his opponent. He can't really see if they're moving into the net, so he was scared. If he was just blocking
19,
it straight,
20.
That someone will be standing there, so he was going cross. The idea was fine.
2 match points saved. 1 more remains. Time. of All England champions once again. 21-19, and for a second consecutive year, it is heartache for Hayakawa and Endo. Well, for Indra Sethiawan, he now has achieved all of the big ones as far as badminton is concerned. He adds the All England title to his two world titles and his Olympic title from Beijing in 2008. The Indonesian coaches celebrate as well. But let's give thought to the Japanese pair. You need two good pairs to make such a good final. 21-19, 21-19, and the Indonesians are champions. This, the final rally, a shame it had to end on an error when it's been such a terrific match. The moment of victory, the celebration for Mohamed Hassan. Indonesia have men's doubles champions once again after an 11-year drought.
So let's get a word with our champions, Mohamed Hassan and Hendra Sethiawan from Indonesia. Yudo is our translator. How special was that?
Seberapa istimewakah kemenangan tersebut?
Sangat istimewa buat kami. Terima kasih atas dukungan supporter Indonesia. Terima kasih yang nyaksin juga di rumah. Terima kasih buat doanya semua.
Very special to us. Thank you very much for the Indonesian supporters. Thank you very much for all the prayers that you have given to us.
How important is it to have such a noisy band of supporters?
Seberapakah pentingnya memiliki dukungan supporter yang berisik?
Ya, kita merasa seperti di rumah sendiri ya, walaupun main di Inggris. Jadi, terima kasih banyak.
Thank you very much. We feel very much at home, even though we're playing in Great Britain.
Let's hear it for our champions, Mohamed Hassan and Hendra Sethiawan. Yonex All England Open Badminton Championships. Please welcome Shuichi Yoniyama, Executive Managing Director of Yonex Europe, Diana Troke, Member of the Badminton England Board of Directors, and Paul Eric Hoyer, President of the Badminton World Federation.
Our dignitaries introduced.
Now, before we celebrate
fans
with our athletes, let's mark the contribution of our officials. Our umpire from Denmark, Jakob Sindberg, and the service judge pair, Aka Andersson of Sweden.
Jakob Sindberg, the umpire for that men's doubles final. And the service judge get mementos. Great honour for our court officials to be chosen to officiate at an All England final. The world number twos, Kenichi Hayakawa and Hiroyuki Endo. For a second consecutive year, they have to settle for second best.
Shuichi Yoniyama presenting the runners-up medals. and of course the MetLife Snoopy mascots. Let's hear it for our runners-up, Hiroyuki Endo and Kenichi Hayakawa of Japan. And now let's hear it for our winners from Indonesia, Mohamed Hassan and Hendra Sattara.
The world champions are now the All England champions, Mohamed Hassan and Hendra Sattara.
Receiving their medals from Diana Troke.
A seventh career title for the Indonesians. And a precious first All England title for the man, Setiawan, who has won so much in the world of badminton.
To our winners. And finally, receiving the coveted trophy from Paul Erik Hoyer. The Yonex All England Open Men's Doubles Badminton Champions. Let's hear it for Mohamed Hassan and Hendra Sattara.
So both pairs take their lap of honour at the NIA.
Crowds getting this close to the stars.
Just to remind you, ladies and gentlemen, Nathan Robinson, one of Badminton England's star performers, signing autographs. And even our badminton stand in the concourse right now. If you fancy giving Nathan Robinson his signature, add it to your autograph collection. He's at the Arab badminton stand in the main concourse right now.
Oh, Indonesia!
Wayne Smith and the team of officials.